अवधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः.
The fourth shloka. The meter will be slightly different, so you try to. I'll also try to fit it in, so we'll see how it goes. Yes. From the beginning? Sure.
Yeah.
Okay. Mano. So we know the tune, so we can all do together.
Mano nivrittif paramo pashantihi. सातीर्थवर्या मणिकर्णिका च ज्ञानप्रवाहा विमलादिगंगा साकाशिकाहं निजबोधरूपा यस्याविदं कल्पितमिन्द्रजालं चराचरं भाति मनोविलासम् सच्चित् सुखैका परमात्मरूपा साकाशिकाहं निजबोधरूपा कोशेषु पञ्चस्वधिराजमाना बुद्धिर्भवानी प्रतिदेहगेहं साक्षी शिवः सर्वगतोऽन्तरात्मा साकाशिकाहं निजबोधरूपा साकाशिकाहं निजबोधरूपा.
So we are winding down and summarizing now in the next two shlokas. So the gears change a bit in terms of the tune only, okay?
काश्याम हि काश्यते काशी
काशी
सर्वप्रकाशिका
साकाशी विदिता येन
तेन प्राप्ता हि काशिका.
तो लवली प्ले ऑन द वर्ड काशी हियर. So nija bodha rupa, I am atma, I atma, in that kashi, in atma, kashi kashyate. So kashi, the place, Varanasi, ityadi, that shines in me. Because what is that place? It is a name and a form, correct? Although it is Tirtha Varya, the holiest of the holy, and it has all the ghats including the Manikarnika ghat. It is a Shakti Pitha, because Manikarnika meaning the earring, no? That fell there, and therefore it is one of the Shakti Pithas. So with all that, that location, that place, physical place, where does it shine? Kashyam. Okay, for those who are learning Sanskrit, you will recognize and get excited. Yes, seventh case. Feminine. So in me Kashi shines Kashi. How come? Because Kashi Sarva Prakashika. Kashi anyway means light, and therefore everything is illumined by me consciousness. That's the beauty of illumination. So it's still winter time in India, at least, you know, whatever is our version of winter in Bombay. Earlier you used to go for a walk at 5 o'clock. Now at 5 it's still a bit dark. But still you venture out with the help of street lights. As you are returning, everything is bathed in light. Earlier when you started walking, there were a lot of silhouettes, shrubs, trees. Maybe one ghost, maybe one robber. Maybe I better watch out. I can't see clearly. I don't know what all this is about. Andhakara, little bit. Because of street lights and therefore the shadows also. My own shadow can scare me. And of course the shadows of other people. Also shadow personalities can scare me. But when I'm returning, then that tree, that shrub, everything, every silhouette, whatever was in darkness, all comes to light. One by one they came to light. No. They're all bathed in golden light. That I am that Kashi. Because I illumine the entire world. I illumine even my Jiva Srishti, my mini subjective world, my ideas, my stories, my experiences, my past, my emotions, my identities, my conflicts, my resolution of conflicts, my spiritual pursuit, my non-spiritual pursuit, my literally spiritual pursuit, etc., etc. Everything is illumined by me. That I am that consciousness, I am that Kashi, because I illumine everything, Sarva Prakashika. Sa Kashi Vidita Yena, the one who knows this Kashi, Tena Prapta Hi Kashika, that person gains, truly gains Kashi. So we see the reflection of this in the Upanishads also. And so here Adi Shankaracharya very beautifully presents that the one who knows Brahman gains Brahman. So here he is using the word Kashi. So clean, straight, simple, which signifies that we have truly made the transition from being a mumukshu to a jignyasu. Mumukshu to a jignyasu, the one who was desirous of being happy, of wanting to feel complete, has recognized that all my feelings and so on and so forth are not happening or are happening because it's all centered on that one conclusion, I am a limited human being only. That only is to be underlined, okay? And that's what causes the problem. So this jignyasu, who has been exposed to a lot of the shastra. This is very interesting, this parampara praptam word, exposed, is a very nice word, obviously from Pujya Swamiji. That you're not really doing anything. You're listening to the shastra, but you will only hear it in this parampara, Arshavidya parampara, that we're saying you expose yourself to the shastra. You are actually not involved. That you have used your will, your atma balam, in all your pursuits to such a great extent that it can just drop. Because in all moments of happiness, there is lot of surrender. You're not trying to control and manipulate and do this and that and everything. There is surrender. You've used the will so much that it can drop. Paper also can drop and can be picked up as well. So, this jignyasu who has been exposed to Shravanam, been exposed to the Shastra, has done whatever it takes because it's an important commitment. There is no casualness in the approach. that person indeed gains Kashi by recognizing that I am that Kashi. Okay. So this is the true pilgrimage. This is the true Tirtha Yatra. So we can move on to the last shloka. Kashi Kshetram Shariram Tribhuvana Janani Vyapini Jnana Ganga. Bhakti Shraddha Gayeyam Nija Guru Charana Dhyana Yoga Prayagaha. Vishveshoyam Turiya Sakala Jana Manasakshi Bhutontaratma. Dehe Sarvam Madiye Yadivasati Punastirtha Manyat Kimasti. Punastirtham Punastirtham Manyat Kimasti. Okay. The shariram, the body, is the kshetram, Kashi kshetram. And some of us may know the shloka, Deho Devalayav Proktaha. How many do not know this? Okay. Very beautiful shloka. Deho Devalayav Proktaha. Proktaha, it is said that Deha, the body, is a Devalaya, is a temple. House of the Lord. Okay. Deho Devalayav Proktaha. Jiva Deva Sanatanaha. What about this Jiva? So has really been Deva. For how long? Became very holy? No. Sanatana. Since a very, very long time, eternal. Deho Jival. No, sorry. What was that? Deha Deva. Deha Deva Layav Proktaha. Jiva Deva Sanatanaha. Tyajet Agnana Nirmalayam. So Nirmalayam, meaning flowers that have been offered in the temple, when they become old they are, or wilted, referred to as Nirmalayam. So many things have been offered in the name of Kama, Karma, etc. But what is it? It is like Agnanam. So Tyajid Agnana Nirmalayam. Those wilted flowers are like Agnanam, because this, the source of this Kama, Krodha, Moha, Mada, Matsarya, etc., etc. The whole jingbang, okay, is all avidya. What is to be done with it? Do I have to hold it very dear to me? You have been a great and very nice, faithful friend. For all time's sake, I hold on to you. No. Tyajet, please. Tyajet, may I give up. Tyajet Agnana Nirmalayam Soham Bhavena Pujayet. So this is called Atma Puja, okay, and we do it as a part of the puja steps. Soham bhavena pujayet, that I am doing puja with what bhava? Saha is who? He, okay, not because we have a gender bias. Saha is a masculine pronoun, that's why, okay. So saha aham. Saha aham soham becomes soham. Saha aham bhavena pujayet. With this recognition that he is me, as I give up this agnanam, how to give up? Obviously with vidya, with jnanam. I am doing this puja. So if you have observed some of the priests doing the puja, they will, of course, they do nyasa, you know, all that they'll do. And then they will. So even when you do this, when you put the tikka and all, this is all a part of your Atma puja. This is a part of the culture. So you're doing Atma puja every day. You are recognizing that you and he are one. Or you, even if it's not clear to me, I am praying for that. This is the culture. So then, what is the scope for self-esteem issues and core issues and whatever else? Look at this. If, you know, since childhood, if you are doing this, and you understand the meaning, obviously somebody explains the meaning to you, that you are great. Like one little child I was talking to, so we were doing puzzles together, and so we finished the puzzle of the tiger. So I said, what sound tiger makes? So he made the sound. I said, do you get scared of the tiger? Saying, no, I am a strong boy. Who told you you are a strong boy? My papa told me I am a strong boy. Okay, so 4-year-old fellow, papa said, I am strong boy. The culture is saying that I am Ishvara. Okay? So then, all my issues and all, whatever the issues are, play of karma, if there is a problem in this world, there is always a solution. If hunger is a problem, food is there, available, to be accessed, to be procured, so on and so forth. So this is the thinking, this is the understanding in the culture, and that is reflected here, that this shariram, don't take it for granted. It has come after many, many births and many, many lifetimes, and this brilliant combination of punya papa. Thank God you have been a great papi also. So you got a human being, sharira. Otherwise you would have been lamenting in Devaloka. You know, ki how much more music, how much more dance, how much more apsara watching and dancing and whatever else. Okay, how much more? So what? I mean, iske baad now what? Now what? You know, what's next? So this sharira, moksha is possible in this sharira. And therefore, this shariram is Kashi Kshetra. It is indeed a Tirtha. It is a holy place. And what makes it truly holy is Jnana Ganga. So whenever Kshetram is said, body is said, mind is included in it, okay? It's because of that Cartesian influence we have, we make that dualistic paradigm of mind-body. But otherwise, when we say body, mind is included. So what makes this Shariram Kashi? Because of the flow of Jnana Ganga. And she is all-pervasive. And this, just as Ganga, you know, Devi Ganga, flows in three worlds, as we know from the Purana. So this, the three states of experience for us, in terms of the waking state, the dream state, and the deep sleep state, Jnana Ganga flows through this body. And what is the truth of that? What is that Jnanam saying? That Ayam Turiyaha, that this is fourth with respect to the three. Turiya means fourth. Chaturtham Manyante Sa Atma Sa Vikneyaha. So it is said to be the fourth with respect to these three states of experience that everyone undergoes, and that Atma is to be known, that Atma is already known. Then where is Prayaga? You know Prayag is where this confluence takes place. So where Ganga Yamuna and Saraswati meet, where of course the Kumbha is going on at the moment. So Snanam in that Prayaga is considered an important part of one's religious life. Those who seek to go. It's very beautiful to see. How many of you all have gone to the Kumbha Mela? Any Kumbha Mela. It is a once in a lifetime, you must go. Swamiji will not like it. I am doing Kumbha Mela promotion. But still, I'm not promoting this Kumbha. Any Kumbha is okay. But it's, if and whenever you have an opportunity, it is worth going to a Kumbha Mela. Because you see the Shraddha of millions in this country. They may or may not know, they may or may not understand, but what they know is good enough for their world. And for all of them, whether they are seeking a job, a child, they are seeking welfare of their children, that Shraddha, that trust, that by going and having that snanam in this prayaga, I will be blessed. My family will be blessed.
Is it similar to the people or the pilgrims going in the month of Shravan?
There are all kinds of Tirtha Yatras.
They live a completely ascetic life when they go up to be carrying the Ganga.
No, that is totally different.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. That is different. Kavayas and all, like in the northern part, no, especially Haridwar, Rishikesh, that is different. Kumbha, and especially Prayaga, and that's where I'm taking off on. That this place is holy because of the merging of these three rivers. Of course, Saraswati is underground. What is the Prayaga for me? It is my bhakti. Bhakti is love. Okay, parama prema swarupa. That is bhakti. So my love for Ishvara, when that comes together with my shraddha for, here of course the guru is being mentioned, nija guru, your guru, and his feet, charana, guru charana. So nija guru charana. So not like we have a feet fetish, okay? Everyone is diving for the feet, what is this? So people from other cultures, they don't understand what's wrong with these people. You meet someone, you go straight, dive for the feet, you don't look at them. But anyway, it's a cultural expression of respect, okay? But feet as a foundation of that, in other words, representing this Shraddha for the Guru is really Shraddha for the Shastra. Shraddha, I am not translating as belief. Shraddha is trust. That this Shastra has worked for millions of people and it will work for me. Because I see it as a means of knowledge. And because I am a logical person, I have seen the limitations of my logic, and therefore I have working trust in a means of knowledge called the Shastra. So when Ishwara Kripa and Guru Kripa and Atma Kripa come together in this Prayaga, in this confluence, then magic happens in Prayaga. Okay, that Atma Kripa is what? My dhyanam, my contemplation, my understanding, my recognition that I am that Sarva Prakashika. But how I understood I am Sarva Prakashika? White light of meditation happened, Shakti Sparsh happened. All those happenings may give me some insights. But because of my commitment, my love for Ishvara, which is not Ishvara's responsibility, by the way. Okay? So Ishvara is blessing me all the time. Do I recognize that I am being blessed? Who will recognize it? I have to recognize it. Because it's all over, all the time, every moment is a blessing. So I recognize Ishvara Kripa in my life. I recognize Guru Kripa if I have a Guru. If I don't have, and if I am seeking, then as they say, what do they say? When the student is ready, the Guru appears. It's true. It's true for everyone. If the Guru has not appeared for you, the corollary is, I am not ready. The Guru may be very much around, but I have not discovered the Shishya in me. That takes a lot. To be a Shishya is not an easy role, because I am an achiever, you see, high achiever. So to be a Shishya, to recognize and to be vulnerable in a relationship is not easy for me. If I have some trust in some people, then I can perhaps extend it to a Guru. It's working trust, and that's fine. There is no pressure to have great Shraddha, not at all. Working trust and recognizing that the Guru is only saying what the Shastra is saying, just a mouthpiece, faithful mouthpiece of the Shastra. So again and again I look at my life in the light of the teachings of the Guru. Guru Shastra. Shastra, what is Shastra? Revealed knowledge by Ishvara. And as I am seeing these teachings, how am I blessing myself? Atma Kripa, so important. Ishvara Kripa may be there, and that's the truth for most of us. Ishvara Kripa is there, Guru Kripa is there, Shastra Kripa obviously is there, but Atma Kripa may not be there. That what I need to do, I don't do. Why? I am very casual about it. Theek hai, yaar, time hai. Or I convert all the teachings into shoulds. You've had it if you do that. Okay? So when there is teaching about Viveka, you say, I should have Viveka. I don't have Viveka. Relax. Don't create so much pressure for yourself. It'll be gentle, be kind, be relaxed about it. Of course, if Ishvara Kripa is there, of course there'll be more Viveka. Of course, I have the guts to be objective. I don't have enough Vairagya. Maybe I must take Sannyasa, whatever else. You may admire someone. Maybe someone is a role model for you. But you don't have to be like that person. There's no pressure. But we will create pressure for ourselves, because from childhood we are used to disciplining ourselves by saying, no, you should do this, you should not do that. And maybe that was required at that time. But moksha is not about shoulds and should nots. It transcends all shoulds, all should nots. So that Atma Kripa, that I go with the words of the Shastra, I do what is required, and indeed that is Prayaga, that is the confluence of Ishvara Kripa, Guru Kripa and Atma Kripa. I am Turiyaha, I am that fourth, Vishveshaha, the Lord of this entire Vishwa. Vishwa is in universe, also my good friend. Sakala jana mana sakshi bhutontaratma. So here, is it only me? Only me? No. Sakala jana. we are all the same pinch?
Yes, same pinch.
Sakala jana, each and every being, that turiyaha, that is the truth of the sakshi, the one who is the witness of all states of experience and whatever happens in those different states. Antaratma being said only if with reference to what is the most intimate, what is innermost. And that, so therefore, having heard all this, yadi, if madiye sarvam dehe, this sarvam, if everything exists in my body, then yadi vasati, if all this exists in my body, then what? Punaha anya tirtham kimasti, is there any other place that is as holy as I am? Because I am that Kashi, I am that Sarva Prakashika. Can there be anything that is more holy than me? Can there be anything that is more sacred than me? Here, he is not putting down a Tirtha Yatra. Okay, this is very important. Otherwise, you say, no, no, I don't need to go here, I don't need to go there. You are welcome to go wherever. Okay? But why are we going on a Tirtha Yatra? Because we want Punya, right? Or you're going, just by the way, you're going. Or you're going to fill, whatever it is. You go to a place because you think you lack. I don't have enough Punya, so I am going there and I will get some Punya. Or I am doing some sort of activities, etc., etc. But if you see that you are untouched by all the Punya Papa. Punya Papa, of course, applies to the body, mind. And all that is easily managed, handled, etc. If you are untouched by Punya Papa, you are the holiest of the holy, you are indeed that Kashika, then is there, rhetorical question, okay? Rhetorical question means the answer is in that question itself. Is there any other place that is as holy as you are? Because you have discovered that you are, you accommodate as Vishveshaha, as Lord Vishwanatha, you accommodate Kashi as well. You accommodate Kashi, you accommodate the ghats where you have cremated your many, many identities. You accommodate Manikarnika, you accommodate Jnanaganga, the Shastra. You accommodate all the devotees who are there lined up on the banks. You accommodate all your lifetimes, whatever be the lifetimes, hippopotamus, buffalo, so on and so forth. Whatever it be, all your everything is accommodated in you, because you are the source of space and time, and you are the source of Kashi. Iti Srimad Shankaracharya Virachitam Kashi, there's a spelling mistake, Kashi Panchakam Samaptam. Samaptam is never Samaptam. So we will chant the first shloka again. Mano nivrittif paramo pashantihi Tirthavarya manikarnikacha Jnana pravaha vimaladiganga Sakashikaham nijabodharupa Sakashikaham nijabodharupa. Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate
Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.